Pretend you're a doctor. Someone comes up to you and says, I've got this amazing artificial intelligence system that can tell you whether a pneumonia patient's gonna die. You think that sounds really helpful, so you take it for a test drive and you plug in some patient data. The system says that because this patient has asthma, they're more likely to be low risk. Hang on, asthmatics are high risk. What's happening here? Is the system wrong? Or asthmatics are given more aggressive pneumonia treatments, so do they survive more often? Or is this a translation error? Maybe asthma equals low risk isn't what the system thinks, it's just what it says. And are you willing to trust that system without knowing for sure? You're not the only one in this situation. We use AI in many, many places where we need to know exactly how it works or people are going to get hurt. Places like courtrooms and child protection agencies. In these cases, it's absolutely vital we know what's going on inside the system. That's why my research is about checking whether our translations of the AI's thoughts are correct. But let's rewind a bit. Why does AI need translation, and why do you need me to tell you whether it's correct? So forget movie AI like WALL-E or HAL 9000. What we mean by AI in the real world today is not something sentient, it's just a really, really big maths calculation. These mathematical models do some pretty sophisticated stuff, so they tend to be complicated. If you think of something like a medical system, it's going to have thousands and thousands of parts to its calculations, and that will be on the simple side. Something like a self-driving car is going to have billions of parts to its calculations. So when things go wrong, like you might have heard on the news about the chess robot that broke a child's finger, trying to figure out what went wrong with even a simple model is going to be difficult. So we can use tools called explainable AI to translate these calculations into something that's a bit more human understandable. But here's the thing, can we be sure that a completely separate piece of software is going to translate the model well? Because a bad explanation is worse than no explanation at all. Imagine if you'd taken the pneumonia system at face value, people might have gotten hurt. That's where my research comes in. What I'm working on is a way to test these explanations before we use the system. Like before, the pneumonia system says asthma equals low risk, and I can tell you if that's what the system actually thinks. And then you can decide whether you want to trust that system before you treat your patient. And it's not just you, the doctor, but all those other situations I've mentioned before as well. We use AI to help us make some pretty big decisions, and my research can help us make sure that these systems are reliable, and most importantly, safe.